Metro Manila, the Philippines. A city overflowing with humanity, whose infrastructure cannot cope with the daily needs of its more than 14 million inhabitants. A city where excessive opulence lives alongside abject poverty. A city of contrasts and clashes. A city where 80% of the population lives below the poverty line and is locked in a constant daily struggle for survival. In a country where social services are practically non-existent. You pay to go to school. You pay when you're sick, and you pay when you die. Many families survive on only the monthly income they receive from family members working abroad. It seems that overseas workers, people, are the Philippines' largest export. And it is no wonder that many Filipinos want to leave their homeland to seek greener pastures overseas. In this noisy, overcrowded, and polluted city, it is very easy to give up hope and leave your fate in the hands of the saints or Mother Mary. But our story is about a young man who refuses to give up hope despite the odds stacked against him. His story is not unique, but he is.
The proclamation of martial law is not a military takeover.
For 20 years, from the 1960s to the 1980s, the Philippines was ruled by Ferdinand Marcos. Supported by the United States, Marcos and his wife, ex-beauty Queen Imelda, ruled the Philippines with iron fists, the only Catholic country in Southeast Asia. They controlled the media, stifled political opposition, and institutionalized corruption into the governmental system. But when Marcos's political adversary, Ninoy Aquino, arrived in 1983 from political exile in the United States and was assassinated at Manila Airport, many fingers pointed to the Marcos's as the perpetrators. Demands began to grow for the resignation of Ferdinand and Imelda. And even the United States began to distance itself from the brewing unrest. Millions of ordinary but angry Filipinos took to the streets. They eventually stormed the presidential palace, but it was too late. The Marcoses had fled like rats in the night, taking with them gold from the coffers of the country's central bank. They had been granted political asylum in Hawaii, courtesy of Uncle Sam. This was a largely bloodless revolution and was dubbed the EDSA Revolution, named after a large highway where many of the revolutionaries gathered for their rallies. People power had come to the Philippines. Amid a sea of popular support, Ninoy's widow, Cory Aquino, assumed the presidential mantle to become the Philippines' first female president. But Cory was a housewife, not a leader, and the Philippines failed to prosper under her rule. General Ramos was the next person to take over the presidential reins, under cause of massive vote rigging and electoral fraud by the opposition. But under President Fidel Ramos, the Philippines did enjoy some stability and growth, partly because Ramos controlled the army generals, and partly because America liked this West Point man. But systemic corruption was still allowed to flourish under his regime.
Ako si Joseph Ernesto Estrada.
Ay mataimtim na nanunumpa.
Ay taimtim na nanunumpa.
Natutuparin ko. Nang buong katapatan at sigasig. Ang aking mga tungkulin. Bilang Pangulo ng Republika ng Pilipinas.
In 1998, popular Filipino movie actor Joseph Estrada, an idol to millions of poor Filipinos, became the next president. It seemed Filipinos were desperate for a hero to believe in, to look up to, and to give them guidance. But after less than 2 years in office, Estrada was accused of large-scale fraud and corruption by his political opponents.
Don't trust him anymore.
We will stay here until Estrada steps down.
Another EDSA revolution occurred. Although this revolution did not come from the heart of the people, but was manufactured by the politicians, led by the diminutive Gloria Arroyo.
Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. Vice President of the Philippines, do solemnly swear that I will faithfully and conscientiously fulfill my duties as President of the Philippines.
Without a public vote or referendum, but with judicial and political support, Gloria, or GMA as she was nicknamed, was sworn in as the next President of the Philippines. Many say illegally.